If you're watching this, you're probably familiar with counterfeit flash memory storage devices, which advertise attractively large storage capacities at prices which seem to be too good to be true, and that's because they are too good to be true. I did a video about one of those back in 2015, which now has over 2.5 million views, but I'm not here to talk about those. All of these USB thumb drives you see here are legitimate. But some of them, including some from well-known brand names, cheat you out of a little bit of their advertised capacity. I first discovered that when I had this 128GB SanDisk USB drive, which actually is 128GB. I'm going to put it in my Mac and use Disk Utility to show its true capacity. And there it is, 128.04GB. So yes, indeed, this drive does give us 128GB. So I was happy with this and I wanted to get another one. Well, I found this from SanDisk. You can see it's quite a bit smaller and now it's a USB 3.0 drive, so it's a lot faster than the old one. And it also claims to be 128GB, except when I plugged it into my computer, I discovered that its real capacity is only 124GB. And here's that newer, smaller SanDisk drive, which also claims to be 128GB. But if I put it in, click on it, it shows up as only 124.22GB. So they're cheating us out of 4GB of its rated capacity. So I emailed SanDisk to complain about it, and at first they insisted that the discrepancy in storage capacity that I saw was due to the discrepancy between binary gigabytes and decimal gigabytes. They said what you are observing is the difference in the definition of 1 GB by operating system versus product manufacturers. Operating systems use a binary system which will represent a lower number of GB than the decimal-based system used by manufacturers to define the capacity of products. But that's not actually true because I'm using a Mac which does measure drive capacities in decimal gigabytes. So I explained that to them and they wrote back, this drive does in fact have 128GB of total memory. Some designs have slightly different user available storage due to optimizations that are used for the performance and endurance of the products. Due to this, the available space for data storage is less on this flash drive. They said, I understand that the explanation provided to you is not up to your expectation, but this is how the product is designed. And in another email, they said, this is disclosed on our packaging and marketing materials when you see the statement, actual user storage less. So even from a well-known and well-respected brand name like SanDisk, there's a chance that you're not getting the advertised capacity of the USB thumb drive or SD card or SSD or whatever else you buy because of that statement, actual user storage may be less. So I'm going to go through all these USB thumb drives and see which ones are actually giving us their advertised capacity and which ones are cheating us out of a little bit of it and hoping we won't notice. On this side, I have the well-known and well-respected brand names. And on this side, I have some of the cheapo no-name ones, but these are legitimate drives. They're not counterfeits. Here's a Lexar 8GB drive. And indeed, it has a true capacity of 8GB. Let's see the exact amount. 8004812800 bytes. So yes, it is 8GB exactly. So that one is being truthful in its advertised capacity. A PNY 64GB USB flash drive. 64.95GB. So they're actually giving us a little bit more than the advertised capacity. A Patriot XT Exporter 4GB drive. 4.01GB. So yes, it is 4GB. So we're doing okay so far. Here's a PNY 64GB USB 3.0 drive. Aha! 61.73GB. Not the claim 64GB. So they're cheating us out of a little bit of it. Here's the actual capacity, 61733863424 bytes. So this one is a cheater. PNY, shame on you. Here's an older PNY drive, 8 gigabytes. And that is, whoops, get out of that, 8.1 gigabytes. So we are getting our advertised capacity a little bit above it. So somewhere along the line, just like SanDisk, PNY went from giving us their actual advertised capacity to cheating us out of a little bit of it. Now here's a verbatim drive. It doesn't say its capacity, but it's going to be some kind of standard value. Or at least it should be. Store and go. 31.14. I would assume that's supposed to be a 32 gigabyte drive, but again, they're cheating us out a little bit of it. I mean, you could maybe say, oh, that rounds up to 32, but not according to the math I learned. If it was 31.51, I would say, okay, yeah, it's rounding up to 32, but not 31.14. So they are cheating us out of a little bit of it on this one as well. Here's another PNY 64 gigabyte thumb drive. Untitled. Whoops. And again, they're cheating us out. It's not 64 gigabytes, it's 61.96. So not even 62 gigabytes we're getting out of what is supposed to be a 64 gigabyte drive. So far, the cheating brands are PNY, Verbatim, and SanDisk. Now here's an Enfane USB thumb drive made to look like a cassette tape, but that's the actual part of it. I believe this is supposed to be a 16 gigabyte thumb drive. So we'll see how much we get out of it. And indeed, we're getting 16.11 gigabytes. So that is the actual true capacity. Recognize this? That looks like that photo stick or whatever it's called. So this is one of those no-name drives which they can print anything you want on them. I don't know what the actual capacity is supposed to be of this, but we'll find out. 2 gigabytes, and we do indeed get 2.12 gigabytes out of it. So that is a true capacity drive. Here's an HP 4 gigabyte drive. I think I formatted this in Linux, so it may not show up as anything that it can recognize. Yeah, he wants me to initialize it, but I will initialize it. And here it is, 4.04 gigabytes, so this one is giving us the rated capacity. Now here's one of those no-name drives, CompuCessory 4 gigabytes. These, in my experience, do give you the rated capacity. And indeed, 4.02. So that's good. Here's a totally no-name one. I wrote on it 16 gigabytes. We'll see what we get out of that. 15.72, which rounds up to 16, so close enough. Not bad. Here's a totally blank one. I didn't even write anything on it. We'll see what this one is. 15.94, which rounds up to 16, so again, pretty close. Not going to complain about that. This one I wrote on it 32 gigabytes. So far we're doing pretty good with these no-name ones. And 31.18, so that one is cheating us out a little bit of it, because that doesn't round up to 32. So it seems like the higher capacity these go, the more you get cheated out of it, because they think you won't notice. Here's an older one. 1 gigabyte, it says on the sticker on there. EVP, Estate Valuations and Pricing Systems, with a nice keychain thing on it. No name. 1.01 gigabytes, so that is correct capacity. So all these drives gave us their advertised capacity within the limits of proper rounding. And this one by PNY actually gave us a little bit more, but these drives cheated us out of some of their advertised capacity. 2 PNY drives, which claimed to be 64 gigabytes, but were not. This Verbatim drive, which claimed to be 32 gigabytes, but wasn't. This SanDisk drive, which claimed to be 128 gigabytes, but was actually only 124. and this no-name drive, which is not actually 32 gigabytes. You could say this SanDisk is a scam disk. These PNYs are partially not yours, and this verbatim is a verbate and switch 'em. I never liked this thing anyway, regardless of its capacity, because it's so tiny that makes it difficult to handle and easy to lose. And also, if you leave this plugged in for a long time, it gets very hot because it doesn't have enough surface area to dissipate the heat of the flash memory chips inside it. So I've been wanting to replace this anyway with something more conventionally sized. And to my dismay, Amazon is still absolutely flooded with fake USB flash drives. If you search for a 1 terabyte USB drive on Amazon, virtually all the results that come up are fake. So I thought it would be safer to go to an actual physical retail store like Best Buy to get a USB flash drive. That way it would be a much likelier chance that it's a genuine item and not a counterfeit. Now I thought I would give SanDisk another chance here with their Ultra USB 3.0 flash drive, 256 gigabytes advertised capacity. But on the back, again, it says 1 gigabyte equals 1 billion bytes. We already knew that. Actual user storage less. I looked at the PNY equivalent, which was a couple dollars cheaper, and that one says it may be less, but this one just says actual user storage less. So that's pretty much admitting it will be less than the advertised 256 gigabytes. So here it is. It definitely is similar in size to the old one that actually did give us its advertised capacity. So we'll see if the same holds true for this. Although I noticed the slide mechanism feels a lot cheaper than on this old one, which is much smoother in operation. This feels like a lighter grade of plastic it's made out of. Okay, we'll see what it comes up as. I'm betting we're not going to get the full advertised capacity, just like it says in the disclaimer. There it is. And indeed, we're only getting 250 gigabytes instead of the advertised 256. Percentage-wise, that's a little bit better than this one, which lost 4 gigabytes out of its advertised 128. So if we doubled that, this one would have lost 8 gigabytes, but instead it only loses 6. But I would still prefer a drive that's advertised as 256 gigabytes to actually give us 256 gigabytes. And I think the proliferation of those fake USB thumb drives has actually emboldened the manufacturers of legitimate USB drives to cheat us out of some of their advertised capacity, because they figure enough people will have been burned by one of those fake drives that they'll just be happy to have something legitimate and trustworthy. And even if you didn't lose data on one of those fake drives, they're often terrifyingly slow. So when you compare the speed to one of these, it'll be so blazingly fast in comparison that they figure you probably won't notice that you're missing out on a couple gigabytes of its advertised capacity. And even if you do notice it, you won't be bothered enough to complain about it. But I guess I'm the exception to the rule, because I was bothered enough by it to make this video.